Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info. A team of astronomers is puzzling over an unprecedented discovery, the first ever observed asteroid with its own ring system. The asteroid Chariklo, which is 250 kilometers in diameter and orbits between Saturn and Uranus, displays two rings that are said to be similar in nature to those of Saturn. The study leader says of the discovery, "We weren't looking for a ring and didn't think small bodies like Chariklo had them at all. So the discovery and the amazing amount of detail we saw in the system came as a complete surprise." Why is the discovery of an asteroid with rings so surprising to astronomers?
The discovery of these twin rings around an asteroid and the amount of detail they were able to draw from the observations came as a complete surprise. Chariklo, the asteroid, is the largest member of a class known as the Centaurs, and it orbits between Saturn and Uranus in the outer solar system. Now, the Centaurs have caused some confusion as to the classification difference between comets and asteroids. And as I've mentioned in previous space news, there is no difference. Both asteroids and comets have a common origin in a recent event in the solar system. Now, it was Tom Van Flanden, the astronomer, who pointed out that the characteristics of the orbits of asteroids, particularly those between Mars and Jupiter, those in the asteroid belt, show all the features you would expect of an explosion or some kind of event in the solar system, which involved the ejection of material into space in all directions from within that region of the asteroid belt. Notably, Van Flanden predicted that asteroids would tend to have natural satellites. This was almost universally rejected, but has since been verified many times. Tom Van Flanden was unable to actually explain how a planet might explode. But of course, the Electric Universe relies on the information extracted from the mytho-historical record to show that the solar system was quite different in the recent past, within, say, 10 to 20,000 years, and that part of that chaotic motion in the solar system resulted in the electrical machining of bodies, particularly Mars. And the very fact that we still receive meteorites from Mars is an indication that this reconstruction of the recent history of the solar system is correct. Now, there were kilometers in depth of material removed from the northern hemisphere of Mars and also ripped from the giant electrical scar called Valles Marineris on Mars. So the asteroids and comets are actually made up from planetary material. Now, it's always been recognized that asteroids show the features expected from matter which has been involved in differentiation and the processes on a larger planet. So the origin of asteroids from a planetary surface has been accepted for some time, but comets were supposed to be primordial leftovers. Neither asteroids nor comets are primordial. We have discovered rings around the giant planets in the outer solar system, Jupiter, Saturn, and Uranus, and even Neptune. But the rings of Saturn are the most obvious, and they are composed of water ice. Now, when they were first discovered, it was assumed that they could not have been there for any great length of time, simply because it was expected that the water would be dissipated, either photochemically or by falling slowly into the Saturn's atmosphere. But as is typical of astronomy, they have tried to lengthen the age of those rings, because otherwise there is no good explanation for them, to lengthen the age of the rings to the age of the solar system, 4 billion years. But if they'd been there that long, they should have been contaminated by dust and also been affected by radiation, so that you wouldn't expect them to be so pristine and clean ice. The asteroid Chariklo meets the kinds of things we should expect from a recent event in the solar system, an asteroid with satellites and also with a certain amount of dust, which was probably also a result of the electrical events which formed the asteroid itself. Because one of the features of electrical activity on the surface of a body, like the asteroid, is that it machines material in the form of very fine dust, much finer than the dust expected to be found in the formation of comets. Comets also show this extremely fine dust, which is not explained by the standard theories of comet formation. So all of these simple facts together can explain what has been found and show that it should not have been a surprise to astronomers. They think the rings are likely to have been formed from debris left over after a collision. It must be confined into the two narrow rings by the presence of small putative satellites. I agree that the rings are probably shepherded into the two rings by satellites. However, you do not get the fine dust required to form the rings from a collision. And once again, this is the problem that astronomers introduce into their theories. Everything relies on mechanical collisions, and yet those collisions have been unable to explain the features that are observed on comets and asteroids.
Astronomers' explanations of ring systems in the solar system were formulated prior to the space age. These explanations were based largely on theories of colliding debris, theories that did not recognize the role of electrical and magnetic forces.
Saturn's rings, their knife-edge appearance, and also the gaps between them, which do not have shepherding moons, is better explained by the electromagnetic environment of Saturn, where you have a neat dipolar magnetic field and also electrical activity in the plasma surrounding Saturn, which will have effects which have actually been seen in the form of spokes, rotating spokes in the rings, which are the kind of effect you would expect if there are electric discharges occurring across the rings towards the planet itself. In the case of the asteroid we're talking about here, it's more likely that it is mechanical effects rather than a magnetic field and electrical effects to produce these rings. The fact that Chariklo may have small moons, of course, has led to a further reinforcement of a false idea, and that is it might in turn lead to the formation of a small moon. In other words, the dust and so on in the rings can coalesce to form a satellite. This has never been shown. In fact, the collision between small particles only works up to a matter of a centimeter or so before the collisions will tend to disintegrate those particles once again, so you can never form a solid moon from a ring of dust. This theoretical formation of satellites from a ring of dust on a much larger scale is said to possibly explain the birth of our own moon in the early days of the solar system, as well as the origin of many other satellites around planets and asteroids. This is harking back to the same old story, which is centuries old now. If the satellites were formed in such a way, you would expect a neat gradation in properties of those satellites. We don't find that. Each satellite of Jupiter and Saturn is so different that you wonder whether they actually were formed in the same way and from the same body.
For continuous updates on space news from the Electric Universe, stay tuned to thunderbolts.info.